Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Knit Pretty podcast. It is October 11th, 9 o'clock in the morning, and I was planning to do 2 weeks, and then I'm about a month. So hello to returning viewers and new viewers. My name is Layton. You can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Zella318. This is a podcast about my knitting and sewing and crazy life. First off, I'm really sorry that this is so much later. I kind of wanted to put in stuff that happened when my parents came to town, and that was just last weekend. And so I recorded the second episode and I didn't like it. And so we are trying again because I am much better about what I want to show you. It was really short, and I didn't feel like I was actually doing a good job of being a podcaster. So, with my parents in town, we went out to Herman, Missouri, which is kind of this little winery town. They probably have at least 12 wineries in the area, which is really cool. A lot of German wine, which for someone who started out on dry California, New Zealand, and French wine is almost torture. But there are some dry stuff, and it's really good. And my dad was okay with it. he generally prefers to be drinking the California wines and to not be tortured with highest quality wines in some ways, but they are good wines. I like them. And then there's this mead winery out there. So we went out there, and my mom actually is a bit allergic to grapes, and she found something that resembles wine that she can drink at the holidays, which I'm really happy about. She doesn't really like white wine because she thinks, why bother? And then red wine gives her a rash all up and down her arms. I have yet to develop that, so I'm really happy, but that's what I've been doing. I've been searching for jobs, a couple of interviews, but other than that, I've just been really excited that my parents were in town. We also went out on Saturday and took pictures of a new pattern. And pictures to update a pattern. My special right triangles cowl that I showed on the last podcast as a finished object got photographed. And I just need to redo that pattern a lot. It was done in Microsoft Word. I now have the capabilities to do it much more professionally in an Adobe Suite software. And that's what I really want to do. I want it to look much more professional, much more like my other two patterns that are out, because Owls of Hogwarts is out, which was really fun. My test knitter has gotten back to me. There are some notes I need to make on the pattern that she used much more of a sport weight fingering, very much a heavy fingering. Very much more sport, and so when you do that, it gets very big, and it kind of like you need to be a rasta or have dreads or something to tuck it up in there to make it really wearable, whereas I make mine with on the lighter side of fingering, and it's a very slouchy hat, but it's still wearable. It's not like not going to be an extra long pair. It's going to be very wearable, at least for me. So I'll show you that in a minute, because I need another one. I'm really excited. This has been a really great weekend, and I've gotten a couple of things finished, which for me is great. I've also had one of the worst cases of starditis. And with that, we're going to go on to whips, because these will take a while. I just left. Actually, one of the good whips just fell. So, almost immediately after I last podcasted, I put something new on my needles because I was in that mood to have something just to knit on, yada yada. Wonderful, just knit, 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 knit. This has been since been put on the back burner because we are getting to that point of it being really heavy. And I'm not sure if I need longer needles or if I just need to sit there on the couch and do it. So it is being housed in my Craftsomatic Kitties with Sweaters bag. And there you can see the cat ear from the monster that lives at my house. I'm not sure where Monster is. We'll see if we can find them, if you want to see him. So this is middle of the row. It really was getting too heavy on my needles is what it was. But this is the Venti Shawl by Anthony Casalena. And let me just show you what I've done. I really like it. It's a long, wide shawl. Long, wide crescent shawl. And I am on the last section. But again, as I said, it's getting really heavy on my needles. So the yarn I am using is a Stephen B. inspired design by set from Three Irish Girls. So the black here is a Dorn sock in the S&M1 colorway. I kind of love it. It's really wonderful. It makes me giggle. The other one also makes me giggle. So this gorgeous white with magenta, pink, and gray speckle is Go Flip Yourself on Spring Wheel Sock. Adorn is 80/20 merino nylon, and I think at 410 yards or 420 yards. And then the Spring Veil is 100% merino at 370. So it does act more like a sport. But I don't hate it. I kind of love it. I kind of really love it because it's plusher. It's really soft and squishy. So it is a bit on the back burner right now because it is a kind of table or more a table knitting where I have to have it on a table so that it takes some of the weight off my hands because it is getting really heavy. So I love working on it for a good solid week and a half. And then October 1st came around and I got distracted by something shiny. So that is this gorgeous thing. And I kind of love it. I absolutely love it. Not just kind of love it. I absolutely love this. I think it is great and wonderful. And I will finish it. And if you guys keep me honest, I will finish this thing by November. Or during November. I think during November. Because I have a lot of stuff on my needles for this month that kind of need to get finished this month. And you'll see what I mean in the whips. So that is again living in my gorgeous Craftsomatic Kitties and Sweaters, and oh yeah, That's the lining. It's like a kiddie newspaper. It's proverb of the day. A cat is the masterpiece of nature. Benign feline champions heartworm union. Meteorologist Chili Calico says it's raining cats and dogs out there, and we all know dogs are bad news. So it's really cute. Oh, and that's a cat person. There, you can see it. Zipper pole. So I think it's gorgeous. I think it's really cute. One of the next projects that got started in this kind of interim between the podcast and October 1 was this shawl. It is living in my personal bag. It's a tulip pink, even with the tigers. And it's kind of in my crazy colors that I love, of like aqua and pink and yellow. And only thing that can make it better is if there was like some purple in there. That's kind of my jam. This is Casapinka's, I have a pattern. One and done. So it's a one skein project, and it's, drop stitches. It's kind of, hold it so you don't see, because it is a paper pattern. Drop stitches, really fun, just a crescent with drop stitches that I think is adorable. And it is being done, so I have a little bit done. And it is being done on Three Irish Girls Adorned Sock in the Cirque du Soleil colorway. And here's what it looks like in its skein. That's probably closest to the colors. I kind of love it. And it got cast on because I was in a starditis mood. I had major starditis after I had finished a couple of projects. And needed some new stuff because I tend to like having some easy projects on the needles, and then I get distracted. I got distracted. I'm trying to figure out which one is the next I got distracted project. I think it's the socks. So let me grab them. Oh, no, it's not. It's this. So in my A Homespun House Roses bag is my Kitty Invisibility Cloak. Again, the pattern is by Casapinka, and it's garter triangle on one side, and then you kind of do something to mesh up this lacy triangle. And I needed something that was just knit, because I tend to really love those for certain events, like knitting groups and during guild meetings, knitting guild meetings. And so this is what it is. This is Zen Fingering Superfine Merino, 90% Italian merino and 10% nylon. It is in the Fabulous Splatter colorway. It's the Fabulous colorway in their splatter dyeing technique. And it is being paired with this. Oh, you can see the sparkles. Thank you.
pulling off.
Yeah, that's really clear right there. It is Essential Fiber Arts in their Fairy Lights Base. And I think this is the Cranberry Block colorway. I don't know where my dad is right now. I wish I did. But, and they go back. No, I totally, totally do my bags and my projects that way. So this again is one of those, I had a major case of starditis. It got started, October came. It's on the back burner now. But it is in the cycle of, oh yeah, I really like that and I really want to work on it. It hasn't been like put into the, I don't really want to work on this. Maybe I should just put it back into the closet. So this is out and about. Next start of this project. It was bad, guys. I'm sorry. I get hairs in my head and I start all the projects. I really do. I start every single project. But I was wearing some just regular socks around, like store-bought polyester cotton socks, and I was really loving them. I'm like, I'm a knitter. I can do socks better than this. If I'm loving these socks, just wearing around the house at times, I need to make some socks. So I cast on some socks. They're just plain vanilla socks, and I just have a little after the toe on one of them. And this is a crazy zobber ball. There's some greens, some purples, and pinks in there. And this is half of the ball. The other half is over here. Because I kind of want them to be tall socks. Kind of just want to go until all of it runs out. And so this is the crazy zobber ball. In the Blaster Shimmer color. You can tell I've never spoken German. And it is 75% wool and 25% nylon. 220 meters. And I do just a simple vanilla sock. I do the Fish Lips Kiss heel, and I actually base it off of my very wonky hobbit foot. Very wonky hobbit foot. I did mine, and then I did my parents, and basically my foot is a mesh of the two of them, plus a little bit of flattening here, because this is my right foot. And my foot was flattened. But this is living in my homespun house mushroom bag. It's really nice. It's really small. It's really cute. And I like it a lot. Okay. One second. Things fell off. So, what should I do next? Oh, Mr. Monster is here. He goes, meow. All right, let's go with the thing that basically made October a everything else gets put on the back burner month. It is living in my Disney Villainesses bag. Inside. And I'm the one. This is the invisibility cloak. I'm just going to the bag quickly before I forget which one it is. It's the Stephen West Mystery Knit Along. I showed you that I was planning for it last time, and so if you haven't started, haven't seen anything, and don't want spoilers, close your eyes. I will tell you when to open them. Ta-da! Oh, I just showed you the back side. I didn't show you the front side. There's the front side. Yeah, that's probably the Clematis colorway. Alright, so I am about halfway through section 3 of Clue 1. The cat's over there. He's on my last nerve. He's doing something he probably shouldn't. So, you can kind of see it, but I am using Tosh Merino Light in both the Dr. Zhivago colorway and the Electric Rainbow colorway. So those are combined right here. This purple is Happy Fuzzy's Clematis in the Corey sock. And that's probably the best color I'm going to get here for you because it's just going to go kind of otherwise. This really deep, pretty, like, true purple. And it's in the Clematis colorway. And then this lovely bigness, you can see it right here along the edge, is Zen Yarn Garden Silk Serenity Silk Singles. Say that kind of fast. In the Art Walk Roses colorway. And then obviously that's what we're doing on the sky. That gorgeous gray. So, yeah, so here's Dr. Zhivago Sky. It's a true gray. Like, to me, this is like a gorgeous, true catatonal gray. And then here is Roses. Very gorgeous and variegated. And this is Electric Rainbow. There, you can see a lot more of the colors. You can see a lot more of the colors there. It's so pretty. And then Clematis. Yeah, that's really the color. Yeah, that's about as a little, a lot more red, I think, in person. Yeah. That's better. Yeah. See that red, red purple on the top? That's about the color. So I'm really happy with it. It's what I've been working on the most since the Clue was released on the 7th, but I had to finish up something else before that so that I could devote most of my energy to this because I really wanted to. Because I want to do this in time. I want to do it like a Clue gets put out, I do it in a week. A Clue gets put out, I do it in a week. I haven't ever been able to do that with one of his. But this is actually going really well, especially for a first Clue. It's nothing I haven't seen before on his stuff. Yes, the construction is a bit different, but other than that, like what he's doing in the walks, I've done it before on his stuff, so it's really great. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So, that's what I've been mainly working on, and that's what I've been anticipating, and that's why a lot of stuff is now on the back burner. But it's not the only reason things are on the back burner. There was another project that had to get done before I could start. Before I could start this one. And it's in my WIP! and it's in, it is in my finished objects. So we are going on to not the last whip. But one of them is an old whip, so you can kind of see the in-progress thing for a... It's a saga. And I think I'll save that one for later. But that was, again, one of those, I finished something, I don't really want to do a lot of heavy work on another project. I can just pick this thing up and do a little bit on it, and I can still set it down and know exactly where I am. So, I'm doing a lot of knit-alongs this month. And that's why a lot of other stuff has been put on the back burner. So, this is for Aroha Knits, and I will figure out the other one of it. Aroha Knits did a class for designing, and then they're doing a knit along of the patterns that they designed. And so you can choose any one of the patterns and knit along. And so I looked through the patterns, and they're very pretty. But I always like to have a hat on the needles. I kind of just love hats. And I'm really loving them this year, I think. And maybe within the past couple of months, I have made so many needles. I've probably made within the past couple of months 4 or 6 hats. Okay. Yeah, 4 to 6 hats. So, and this may be number 6, honestly. But it is a really cute pattern. It is the Retke hat by Laura Peters. And I am, and so here it is. They're muted colors, honestly. And this is in the Alexandra's Crafts, it's the Alexandra's Crafts yarn. And the Black Butte base, which is 60% merino, 60% superwash, 20% silk, 20% yak, 400 yards in the Kaleidoscope colorway. I like it. It was a gift from a very good friend whose husband teleworks for a bank in Portland, and he goes up there 4 times a year, and she goes with him probably 2 times a year. It was very sweet of her to go on this. I think she really did look at fiber content, and that it's an Oregon yarn, and there were a lot of things involved in this, and she's very sweet. Not my colors. It took me a long time to figure out what to do with it. So it is a fingering weight, but I am holding it double. I'm holding it double and knitting it. And it's turning out really kind of a nice tweedy. I love the feel of this. Like, it's so plush and squishy that I'm really enjoying this. I'm really enjoying the knit. I am enjoying the yarn. And I think because that was the hat originally, something a little bit less latent, and by that I mean hello on my color schemes would be good for this. Not doing like there are 2 panes of glass between me and the spider but it's like crawling on its web and it's creeping me out. So that's why I chose this for it. And it's kind of, and it's very subtly doing some striping and pooling and stuff. But honestly, it's not bothering me. I kind of like it. And again, it's subtle. It's as subtle as anything I've ever done, which is very, very subtle compared to like the stuff that I do for me. I do for my stuff I do for my mom tends to be a little bit more subtle, but not by much. So that's what's, and it is living in my Slytherin bag. I told you about this, and I told you that this was being sewn for a specific project. Guess who finished that project? In less than a week. Yeah. So, oh, Izzy has found a box to be in, which is great. So it is living in this bag. I always forget things. I do not know what's going on with me. I think I put them in the wrong spot. So it has this cute little zip pool, Slytherin. And I have forgotten how much I love the size of my bags. I really, truly love it. I've been making them bigger for a while because I was doing a lot of shawls. And this is the perfect size for a hat. It really is. Or like my one and done shawl really should move into one of these and I should free up a larger shawl bag. But I love this. I really love this size. It's kind of perfect. The perfect size, especially for me. Especially for the kinds of projects I do, especially the hats. It works really well for socks. I might be making more of these size for a while. I think we are on to finished objects. It was a whip party today. Definitely a whip party. I'm drinking water and tea today. Again, I forget my patterns. I put them down elsewhere and I forget them. Oh, this is sort of a whip. Again, I'll show that in a second. So first finished object. I finished my worm hat. Boing. I actually finished this not long after the last podcast, which is kind of why I had a bit of a vacuum and started projects. It is out of the Oroops Alice and Her Looking Glass colorway. It is the Worm Hat pattern by, I will look it up. And it is really adorable. I love it. It'll be a good hat for this winter because I like wearing hats. I like knitting them, I like wearing them. Even if I take them on and off, my hair pretty much bounces back from them. So, they're cute, and I like them. But it is warm now, from the 70s today. Which is warm for us right now. The weekend, it was gorgeous. It was in the mid-60s all weekend. A little bit cloudy on Friday. gorgeous on Saturday. I think it was gorgeous on Sunday. I slept a lot. I had to get up at a certain time, go have breakfast with my parents before they hit the road, because they are not staying with me in this two-bedroom apartment, where one bedroom is an office or a yarn storage area. And so after, so about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I then proceeded to take an almost 4-hour nap. I'm not sorry about that, but it did throw a bit of a kink in my whole entire schedule. And yesterday I was exhausted too, and so I just, it's been a bit. I wish I had more energy on that stuff, but entertaining people for 2.5 days is exhausting. Yeah, it's exhausting. Making sure they have things to do, making backseat driving / giving directions to my dad so that we can get places, because it's kind of nice not to drive yourself around when your parents are in town. It's exhausting because they are... I had to give my dad very specific instructions about, see that light? That's where you turn. Or you get into this lane now, or X, Y, and Z. And then when we were coming back from Herman, he decided to take a scenic route that turned very scenic, that turned into frustration, that turned into my mom closing her eyes in the backseat, and me looking for the Dramamine. But everything's okay now. Everything's okay now. We survived. My mom and I are happy he has his own Subaru now, because that means he will not drive our Subarus, and he will not drive them incorrectly. Yes, there is the right way to drive our cars and the wrong way to drive our cars. We drive them the right way. Dad drives them the wrong way. Alright, so the second whip, again, this is kind of an older whip because it was done almost right after the last podcast. And this is an older whip here in... the Mish object. And this is probably one of my favorite shawl patterns ever, because it's pretty, it's very easy, it's very potato chippy. And it is Allie Kofi's Razzle. If I blocked it, I probably could get it longer. And it is just, it's smooshy, it's gorgeous, it's a lot of garter on the needles, unfortunately. And so the color, and I finished this not long after the warm hat, because I was looking for just something to knit. I was thinking I would do this knitting loops, everything like that. I had like this much to finish on it, like that, or less to finish on this. I didn't get anything. Did I mention starditis? That's why I finished two objects. Finished two projects, and so I could start all the projects. So the speckle, oh gosh, is it speckle, is Lolo Did It yarn in on her 75-25 base. I'm not sure exactly what she calls it. And the Holly Jolly colorway. This is one of her Christmas colorways. I think she will be having it back for Christmas again. I don't know. Do not quote me on that. But she is bringing back her Halloween ones that she had last year, at least the speckles. So right now, I think you can get Monster Mash if it is still in the shop. So that is, but she does speckles so well. Like, that is, to me, that is a true speckle. Like, just, because it looks like It looks like when you knit it, it's speckled. It's not that when you dye it, it's speckled. It's when it's knit. And I do not know how she does it. Whatever she does, I will buy it. Oh my gosh, it's gorgeous. Because it's just reminds me of Christmas lights. And then the border is Zen Yarn Garden's Serenity Silk Singles. Again, say it sometimes fast. In the Mystic Ocean color. And I still need to weave in the ends. I'm so bad about that. I don't think anybody likes it. But it's just annoying. All right. Now it's the object that made everything else go on the back burner so I could finish it before the Stephen West pattern came out so that I wouldn't have competing middle ones. I think it's my Owls of Hogwarts hat. My haunted Owls of Hogwarts. So. It doesn't, gavels do not show up as much in like this variegated glitter base, but it's so pretty. And I need to put it as a finished object in the O-Loops Ravelry group. There you can see an owl head very well. And it is on the O-Loops Fashion Knot based 75-25% merino nylon stellina. 438 yards, and it's a sock blank. It was a sock blank, and so this is what's left of the sock blank. Knit up, so, oh. Just look at those colors. I love it. So this was my main project for a good week. And it was living in my Slytherin bag. I was very good. It lived in my Slytherin bag. But it got done before I could podcast. And something else needed to go into my Slytherin bag. So this is my last finished object. So on to planning / I need to get the hat done and then I will test one of these on. I think I'm gonna cast this thing first. And there's a bit of a story behind this. A good friend of mine from graduate school, he and his wife just had their baby. Their baby boy, Gideon, at 28 and a half weeks. Her water broke around 20 weeks. So we're happy that they got 8 and a half. We got 8 and a half more in Europe. He is in NICU, and I think they're both lost. I haven't heard. That's hard. He's in his second year of graduate school, and he'll be graduating. And she is so lovely. So I am making them a baby doodle for their son. And it is going to be made out of this baby marble color. And called Citrus Swirl. It's acrylic, but it's gorgeous acrylic. And I will be doing kind of just a simple pattern on it. And it's going to live in my Hook and Gauge Forest Friends bag. But that's what I'm casting that on next after I finish the hat. Because it needs to be cast on. I need to have a blanket for their son. Which, considering now that, like, a car seat blanket or something, car seat cutter, because you can't do babies' blankets until they're 5 or something. So that's the thing in here that is going to be cast on really, really soon. Because it needs to, because they're a really great couple. They're just very sweet, and I have to do something for them, because that's just, I just feel like I need to do something for them. But that's what this is going to be. Okay. Alright, this is the next planning. It is living in this bag that was housing the warm hat. And it's going to be another hat. This time it is going to be in Mohawk wool. And this is 60% merino, 30% Romney wool, and 10% nylon. So it's very, very sheen. But it does have really great volume. And it's going to be a hat for my mom. So since my parents were up, I basically said, Mama, you get to pick out and buy the yarn for your Christmas present. And so I am designing her a hat. I have a pattern in mind and everything, and I'm going to knit her a hat. So it will get cast on, but it will get cast on probably in November, honestly. Because I have a lot of stuff going on with other projects, and the fact that I do need to get Nathan, I do need to get my friends their baby blanket. Because even though he is in NICU, having something for him when he comes home would be great. So, I think that if I do put that up, I'm going to probably donate if it is a pattern that, like, really truly pay for. I think that the donations will probably go to Creamy Burke charity. I will find one to talk about, because on to happier topics. Okay, for the next one, there's a story and a saga behind this, so that's what I said, like, one of the whips was going to be more of a, at the end with this other thing. So, again, my mom was in town, and she has seen me. And so one of the projects I was working on just to have something to work on was this. It is living in my Craftsomatic Wonder Woman bag. And it is my Files shawl design. So I was working on this, and she said it was gorgeous. Do you ever have those people that you're just like, don't say that in front of me because then you now will get one? So this was her. So I was working on this. And she makes comments saying that she really likes it. I'm like, you do know that now you're going to get one. And you get to pick out your yarn for it and everything. So that's the last one. And she had seen the original, which is this one. So it's absolutely massive. I'm a big girl, and it wraps around. It behaves, it rests on shoulders, it's, you have a gradient through it. It's one of my favorites. I designed it, this is what's, and so that's what hers is going to eventually look like. Sort of. Because my mom couldn't pick the normal one. Normal gradients. Instead, there will be crinkling. She picked these gradients. The original has 4. This has 6. The original was 300 yards or 350 yards. This is 600. I get to get creative. I think I do have enough in the main color that it's not going to be a problem to add at least another section of lace panel in there. Maybe to the point that it's ends with lace instead of ends with garter. We'll see how this works. It's going to be a lot of me playing, and I'm probably going to have to put lifelines in. Yeah, I know. But that's probably what's going to have to happen. So that I can just rip that if I need to. So these are the they're done roving gradients. I'm not sure about the color. And I will find that out for you. They did! It is spring has sprung, 100% merino, six 100 yard skein, approximately 5 ounces. Flocking feet, done moving. So, I really like this yarn. I would recommend it. I have another set of their gradients for a different project that's been backburnered. I don't think I was as happy with it as I could have been, but I do love it. And I think I saw something else shining and got distracted. So. But the color that is going with it is this. And it is Zen Yarn Garden Silk Single, Serenity Silk Singles in the Foliage colorway. And I know that because it's 430 yards instead of adorned, which is okay. I use 600 of that I will probably be able to at least put in another two full sections. So a full garter section and then a full length section. We'll see. I may just get the end and just do lace back and forth until I run out of yarn. But this will look slightly different than anybody else's because it's just going to be slightly different. So that hasn't been started yet, because it is a Christmas present. It does need to get cast on sooner, so probably this month when I finish a clue before next month's come out for Stephen West's mystery knit along. That's probably what I'm going to be doing. And it is living in the Slytherin bag. This is my Lip Syncing Ladies Slytherin bag from that I got last year. And I put my tangerine design button Knit in Public Scare the Muggles on there. Okay, so that is all the planning, and so I'm going to go on to some sewing whips, which this one. This one was started last year. I really need to finish it soon. The zipper is in! The zipper is in it! I now only need to sew up the sides. I got so overwhelmed last year doing school and then other stuff and then trying to get things for the knit along done. It wasn't good, but I do need to finish this because this will be the size of my Disney villains. It's really nice sized. I'm falling in love with my small and my big sizes again. Whereas I have been kind of using that medium size for a while. I am falling back in love with the different sizes. And so, I want to get this done partially to move Stephen West into this, but partially because I don't know if next month's challenge is going to be for Harry Potter to go on. I don't want to be prepared. The Hogwarts bag, if I need to. That is my sewing whip, and hopefully this evening it will become a sewing event. So, parents were in town. Did I mention this? And so that means yarn off. The first one is something I got. It is for Electric Rainbow. If I end up needing it for the Stephen West shawl, I will use it for that. If I end up not needing it for the Stephen West shawl, I'll find something else to do with it. Don't know what yet, but I'll find something else to do with it. So my local yarn shop got in a shipment of Zauberball. And so I have been drooling over some colors for a while. And so mommy got this. Mama got this. So the first one is this. It looks like cherries and chocolate. or like cherries and chocolate or cherry blossoms. It is just as Auber Ball 100 in the red to go colorway. And it is 200 meters. And it is 100%, you know, or virginable is what they're calling it. So I don't. So that is one. Number two. This is an interesting color. Oh, yeah, that's better. It's teals and purples and green. It smells like tea. And it is another Auber Ball. But this one is 75% merino, 25% nylon. Or again, they're calling it virgin wool. So superwash, um, 420 meters. And it is in the smoking area color by. Not that I smoke, I just think that it's gorgeous. And then the next one, I mentioned that I grew up in Oklahoma, right? And that, that'll explain my love of the state. So it is this. Much more subtle, much more not my normal colors. It's purples and reds and gorgeous gold, but it's in the Route 66. Yeah, that's just, it's really pretty. This is a crazy problem. This is 420 meters, 70% virgin wool, 20% nylon. It was one of my acquisitions this past weekend, along with the yarn for my mom's stuff and the yarn for the baby. So, lukewarm, not bad. I am drinking. I lost the sachet. It's just some Irish breakfast tea. It's just a one bag cup because I already have my two bag cup this morning. I don't want to eat the lining on my stomach, which I've done before on many occasions. Oh, I air dry. And I have water in my Wonder Woman tumbler. I have a cat who likes to stick his head in any water glass and drink from it, and then put his paw in it and try and like do that. So cups with lids have become my best friends. So let's move on to what am I watching, reading, and listening to? Okay, first of all, watching. Last night was the premiere of the season premiere and CW premiere of Supergirl. I love Supergirl. Oh my gosh, I love Supergirl. Compared to like the Flash and the Arrow, especially Arrow, where it's always been dark. It's been dark since day one. And I get that. I get that that's where it's supposed to be, that Oliver Queen is not some happy-go-lucky guy. but I do like Supergirl because it's kind of more lighthearted. It's very bright, it's very sunny. Callista Flockhart is phenomenal in it. And then we got to meet Superman, and it was wonderful. And the line of, I used to change his diapers, from Kara to some spectators of one of the rescues. It's just, it's very cute. I highly recommend watching it. The first season is on Netflix, and my favorite episode, again, one of these, like, she works so well with other people. There's no competitive banter. There's no posturing. It's a, oh, you're here to help. Great. Let's do this. Kind of attitude towards things. So, her episode with Flash is wonderful. And I think that, and it's really indicative of, like, just her spirit. And so there are some darker moments, and there are some, like, really good moments, and so, I would just watch the Super season and then start watching it when it comes on, because it's very good. I am listening to a lot of albums from now. I have her whole entire album, and if you've just heard X's and O's and American Sweetheart, I would listen to the rest of the album. It's very bluesy, pop bluesy, and it's just, it's really nice. I listen to it just to kind of wind down from the end of the day, and she has her up songs, she has her down songs, she has, like, it's just, it's very good, and it's very, very wonderful to listen to, and this raspy voice. That's perfect for blues. She, like, doesn't completely remind me of Janis Joplin, but there's hints of it here. I'm still working on reading Discovery of Witches. I actually now have the next book, but I'm not going to touch it until I have actually read the first book. But having that one there, I'm like, yes, I need to get through this, so that there's actually another book that I read. But I'm also rereading, because I do a lot of books, and the next one is coming out in November, the Natural series by Jennifer Lynn Barnes. I got a hold of these this summer. And if you like Criminal Minds, you're gonna love this. It is teens working on cases. But it's different. It's, they're all a little quirky. And so they're, it's really, really good. It's just, yeah, I think that it's very well done in that issues are addressed, but they're not, like, heavy-handedly, like, you're going to make this an adult situation. It's very, how do these kids who have been put in these situations and given a lot of freedom in some cases, or not a lot of freedom in other cases, deal with this, and how do they deal with the adults in their lives? So I really, really enjoyed this series. That's what I think. I've been admitting and watching. And I will actually see you next week. I'm going to make this a weekly podcast, and if the episodes get shorter, okay. But last time I felt like I was going through the motions. I didn't have a lot to share with you, so that's why it didn't get cut up. I was like, here's the projects, here's everything else. And so I'm going to try for every week, because I was almost forcing myself to wait 2 weeks to be happy, and I wanted to do it that next week because I really enjoyed it. And then I was so unhappy with that recording that the second episode didn't happen until today. So I think I'm going to do it every week because I really enjoyed the video. I enjoy showing you what I've been doing, and I, because that's a mountain of whips. The mountain of whips needs to not happen again. I mean, I noticed that I wanted to show you immediately when I finished, and things like that. So I think that we're going to do this every week. So until next time, bye!